Well, when I was a senior in high school, I served as a volunteer leader in Club 56. And let me tell you, it was crazy. And I probably had some of the rowdiest fifth grade boys of all time. Actually, I remember one night very well. It was kind of an invite your friend fun night with a bunch of games set up and indoor inflatables. And that night, all the boys in my group had wanted to go play in the inflatables. And so I went over there with them. So we all took off our shoes and we hopped into one of the inflatables. But just as I was getting in, one of the boys quickly jumped out and grabbed my shoes and just started running. He just totally took off. And I realized pretty quickly that night was gonna take a turn from fun inflatables to a game of monkey in the middle with my shoes. And I remember being pretty confused. Like, I'm here to serve, I'm here to try to make a difference, to try to make an impact, but in that moment, I certainly didn't feel like I was making much of an impact. Now, if you serve in Club 56 or Adventure Club or really anything with younger people, or even if you have a younger sibling, you maybe can kind of relate to that same feeling. Well, tonight we wrap up our D group teaching series called For Where You Are by again talking about what it means to make an impact. You might remember that last week, Gretchen talked about what it means to make an impact by influencing the people around you in your life, in your family, in your school, or wherever you are. But tonight, I want to talk about what it means to make an impact through serving. Now, I know we talk a lot about serving. Almost every single week, we share with you guys an opportunity to get involved and to serve others. And many of you, honestly, maybe even most of you, are already doing that, whether it's in your school, in your community, or even here at Chapelstreet Church. But tonight, my goal isn't to ask you to serve or to even to share with you where you should serve as much as it is to kind of help us take a step back and understand two things about serving: why we serve and how we serve. And so tonight, like I said, I want to take a step back and really consider serving by reading what Paul writes to us in Philippians chapter 2. I'll pick up reading in verse 3. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourselves, not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interest of the others. In your relationships with one another, have the same mindset as Christ Jesus, who, being in very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness. And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. In verse 6, Paul says that even though Jesus is God's son, that he's equal to God, that he didn't use that to his own advantage. Now, I don't know about you, but there's something in me that often looks for the easy path in life. If I have a way out, or if there's a way for something to be a little bit easier, I want to find that path and take it. But Jesus doesn't do that. Instead, he takes a totally different approach. He makes himself nothing. Jesus, who is God, who knows everything and is everything, chooses to make himself nothing. He chooses to become a human and enter into our world. He chooses to serve others. And so why do we serve? Well, really at the highest level is because of all that Jesus has done for us, the ways that he served us, and the example that he set for us. And I think that then leads us to our second question, how do we serve? And here's where I think it gets a little bit more practical. Let me read what Paul writes in verses 3 and 4 again. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourselves, not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interest of the others. Be humble. Value others first. Look out for others first. Now, I don't know about you, but that is really, really hard for me sometimes. My tendency is to put myself first. My needs, my thoughts, my wants, those come first. But when Paul talks about how to serve and the example that Jesus set for us in serving, it all boils down to humility. Now, humility is not a super popular thing in our culture right now. We live in a success-driven world where everybody is just pointing out all the great things that they've done. So I think sometimes humility is something that we maybe just don't always understand correctly. Rick Warren, who's a pastor in California, wrote this about humility in his book called A Purpose-Driven Life. Humility is not thinking less of yourself. It is thinking of yourself less. Humility is thinking more of others. What he's saying here is to be humble does not mean to think less of yourself. It does not mean that you're not valuable or that you need to lower your opinion of yourself. In fact, I think it's actually really important that you do understand your value. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10 says that you are God's masterpiece, that God created you and He loves you. And so to be humble, again, it doesn't mean to think less of who you are. Instead, it means to think of yourself less, meaning that you spend less time thinking about what you want, what you need, what makes you feel good, and what's easiest for you, and instead thinking more about other people and helping them with what they might need. And I think that's what I kind of started to learn all those years ago at Club 56, when it shifted from a fun night with inflatables to a game of monkey in the middle with my shoe. I kind of remember questioning everything I was doing. Am I really making a difference? Am I really making an impact in these boys' lives? But as I look back, I think that God was teaching me something. I think He was teaching me that serving, it's not all about me. And at that time, I was pretty frustrated with that situation. I didn't feel like I was making an impact. But as I look back now, I think that that's exactly what those guys needed in that moment. See, I think sometimes we think that if our serving isn't overly spiritual, then somehow it's not as meaningful. But when we think of others first, when we put their needs ahead of our own, I think that's what it means to serve humbly. And it can look a lot of different ways. And for me that night, I think it started by just playing a silly game of monkey in the middle with my shoe. See, serving isn't all about me. And it's not all about you either. Serving's about being humble, putting the interests of other people ahead of your own. And yes, you can do that when you're serving at Adventure Club, when you're volunteering in your school or in your town. But serving humbly, I think, means so much more than that. Paul's challenge to us in Philippians 2 is to have the same mindset as Jesus. And that doesn't just mean when you're signed up for a serving opportunity at church. It means in all of our lives, each and every day. Having a humble mindset, putting others before yourself, those are the things that make an impact in the world around us.